Welcome to Books and Company. Bienvenidos todos. I'm your host, Alberto Rios, and we're joined today by John Lescois, talking about his latest book, The Fall. Welcome.
Welcome. It's great to be here.
We've been having a great conversation, and you've got this book. I believe it's your...
It's my 26th book.
26th book.
It's my 17th New York Times bestseller.
Wow.
It's really
that's
crazy.
An extraordinary, I don't want to call it a career because you're far from finishing that
career.
Oh,
let's call it a career. We'll call it a career in C2.
Yeah. Okay, all right. You now, at this point, know a thing or two about writing.
Hopefully.
But you also got that from others.
Well,
right?
You know, I had a fantastic teacher in high school. As a senior in high school, I had a teacher named Father Stadler. And he believed that it was very good to get A's. It was a good motivating thing because you're trying to go to college. It's a very important semester. And he said, the good thing about this class is you can get, every student in here can get an A. All you have to do is keep writing it over until you get an A. So the first time he gave me an essay, it was for an analysis of William Faulkner's The Bear. And I sat down and I wrote an essay that I thought was very good. I handed it and I got a C minus. And the next time I got a C, and the next time I got another C. And I went in and talked to him about it, and I said, what can I do? He said, well, maybe you want to think about your thesis. You know, how it all begins. And I went back in, I got a B minus. I mean, long story short, 9 drafts later, I finally got an A. And I don't think there's anything in my whole writing life that has been as formative as that month or so, where literally I went home almost every night and rewrote the darn thing.
Wow. No fear of revision.
Well, you better get over it.
That's it. That's
it. You better get over
it. Of course we have a fear of revision, but it takes somebody...
Because the first draft was perfect.
Right. It takes somebody to push us, because that's a very difficult human moment.
It's huge.
We know that if we're in a swimming meet or something, we're willing to practice. We do it in other things, but writing, for whatever reason...
Well, you know, the sense is you've got all that stuff written down and it looks so formidable.
Yeah.
And it has what I've always called the authority of existence, which is a great phrase. Because it has its huge power.
It's there.
And you don't want to change it because you've already worked on it, darn it. I'm not going to change it.
Yeah.
But yet, there it is. And you go back and you change it and you realize, wow, I missed so many opportunities. There's so many better things I could do, choices I could make. And if you just treat it as though it's a craft, you're going to be better at it.
So let me ask you a question. After 26 books, is there a far side to that? When do you let go?
Well, here's the thing, you know, Kinsey Millhone is the, protagonist for, I can't believe I'm not remembering her name immediately. The A is for Alibi, B is for Burglar.
Sure.
Sue Grafton.
Right.
And
she's been on the show.
I had a moment last night at one of my book signings where somebody pointed out after 26 books, I should just go back and rename them all. And I'd be done.
I'm at Z.
I'm done. Just figure out new titles and go for it. So it's fun. It's great.